Hello everybody. I would like to welcome you to the video presentation of the prototype application we have developed for the Primanus project. My name is Stefan Schleyer and I'm the responsible project leader for SKF in the Primanus project. And we have developed and designed a prototype application which is dealing with the issue of gearbox remanufacturing in the wind energy business. I would like to go through all the different tabs of the application and would like to highlight what kind of functionality has been implemented. So if we going to start with the installation base, the first functional tab within the application, you can get an overview of the installation base of the wind turbines. So within the application we have focused on the wind turbines which are installed in Europe, because from our business we are operating from Germany. Europe is the most important market for us, of course. As you can see, you can do a selection per country. That means if you select, for example, France in this case, then it's indicated if by a mouse over event how many wind turbines have been installed in the selected country and also the installed power of the wind turbines. That means in the case of France, we have six wind turbines which are installed and under SKF condition monitoring contract, and the installed power for the six wind turbines is 18 megawatt. So you can do this, of course, for all the other countries where wind turbines have been installed and SKF has an condition monitoring contract for. And this general overview helps us to gain an overview of the installation base we have to take care of, and also, let's say, based on the installation base, maintenance service operations can be planned accordingly. The second functionality or tab within the prototype application is the bill of material search, bill of material retrieving capability, and you have different search fields you can fill in with search criteria. So, for example, you can do a search for a specific product. That means if you know only, let's say, part of the ID of the product, maybe it starts with a B underscore, then all the corresponding and relevant components are displayed in the result screen area. Once selected a specific wind turbine by clicking on the relevant entry, then you get more detailed information regarding the bill of material. That means in this case, you have selected a wind turbine. By clicking on the wind turbine, you can see the components the wind turbine consists of. That means in this case, of course, you are starting at the top level entry of the bill of material. So you see the wind turbine is consisting of a rotor, a drivetrain, generator, support system, electrical systems, and of course the tower. And by, let's say, further selecting the components, you can further drill down into the component structure of the wind turbine. So the next level is, let's say, the rotor. And by pre-selecting the rotor, you can see, okay, rotor is consisting of blades, bearing, and the hub. One additional example for the drivetrain. Here you can see drivetrain is consisting of the main bearing, brake system, and gearbox. And this functionality helps the service technicians to, let's say, retrieve all relevant information which are necessary to do a later calculation and ballpark quote for the gearbox remanufacturing process. Another important parameter which is necessary for doing the calculation for the remanufacturing cost of the gearbox is, of course, what kind of alarms have been produced for a specific type of asset in a certain time frame. So, to implement this functionality, we have implemented an direct, let's say, interface to our condition monitoring systems. That means, by creating an interface which can be plugged into the Premanos ecosystem, we are able to retrieve all alarms information from the wind turbines in real time. And of course, some pre-selection criteria have to be done. So the first selection you have to do is to indicate what kind of alarm you're interested in. So in this case, let's say we would like to have all danger alarms which have been produced in a certain time frame. And then of course you have to indicate what time frame is relevant for retrieving the alarm information from. So you have to start with the time from, that means the starting time within the time frame you're interested in. So in this case, we are taking into account all alarms which have been generated since beginning of this year. And yeah, just to get all produced alarms, we are just saying, okay, every alarm which has been generated in 2015, means end to the year, is interesting for us. So we have filled in the search criteria, and now we would like to retrieve the alarm information. And as you can see, quite a number of danger alarms have been produced in the specific time frame. And just if you do some plausibility checks, looking at the alarm time, yes, the alarm time is produced 16th of February. That means it is exactly in the time frame from 1st January of 2015 up to end of the year. And also the alarm type and alarm, or respectively the alarm level, is correct. So all danger alarms have been retrieved from the condition monitoring online systems. So the service technician has now, let's say, quite a good overview what the installation base of the wind turbine is. Then if he's interested how a specific component is built of, or let's say the structure of a specific component is divided into subcomponents and sub-subcomponents, so to say, this is covered by the bill of material search. And the next tab, or the current tab I'm explaining, the SKF alarms, is retrieving direct information from the wind turbines where, for example, the relevant gearbox has been installed. So if the customer now wants to, let's say, get his gearbox remanufactured, it's almost, or let's say in every case, it's more or less time critical. That means if a certain malfunction on the gearbox occurs, then the customer would like to have, let's say, an immediate replacement. That means to be prepared for these customer requirements, SKF has a stock of different type of gearboxes. So that means the first activity, if a customer requests arrive for remanufacturing a gearbox, would be to, let's say, search within the stock if a suitable gearbox is available and can be shipped directly to the customer. So there is no need for the customer, let's say, to wait until his gearbox has been remanufactured and then shipped back to the wind turbine. So an immediate replacement could be done. And here you have also, let's say, different selection criteria. course we're interested in a gearbox, and let's say maybe we have to, or let's say we would like to look for a specific manufacturer, because for example a Bosch gearbox should be replaced by another one, by another Bosch gearbox. We can define the selection criteria, and as you can see here, okay, we have different kind of Bosch gearboxes in stock. So now let's say it's of course important what the power of the needed gearbox is. So that means this has to fit to the gearbox which should be replaced. And let's say also the type of the gearbox, that means the specific idea, as a specific ID has to fit to what is going to be replaced. So let's say with this activity, it can be checked if the system, if the customer can be supported, let's say immediately, and a gearbox replacement can be done directly. And of course, let's say we have to deal with the issue that the remanufacturing of the gearbox has to be done in any case. So that means even if the gearbox is, let's say, replaced directly, the gearbox of the customer has to be remanufactured, and for this remanufacturing the costs have to be calculated. And let's say to achieve this and do a really good accurate ballpark quote, we have implemented a business decision support system. So that means exactly speaking, we are using this functionality which has been implemented by Loughborough University, which is a consortium partner within the Primanus project, and we are using their BDSS for, yeah, let's say, giving us an indication what the expected remanufacturing cost may be. So we have also to do some selection of the parameters. So of course we are looking for the product type gearbox. Of course the gearbox has to be remanufactured. Then from the manufacturer, so we are sticking to the Bosch example, which we were using in the previous tab. So from the power, okay, we say it's an 1800 kilowatt. And from the condition, we knew it's up to the level of 3. And based on this, parameters and calculation is done by the BDSS. And finally, the result is displayed. So that means we have here now the results for three different kind of activities. That's first for the disassembly. So we now see the range within this cost maybe. So we have the mean cost, which is for the disassembly, in this case 70,242 euro, and then also the lower 90 and upper 90 cost. That means that's, let's say, an indicator what the percentage of potential deviations may be. The similar is relevant for the other activities. So it means for repairing, for the repairing activity as such. So we have also the mean cost, which is in this case a little bit more than 32,000 euro, and the lower 90 and upper 90 cost, which indicate also, let's say, a specific range where a certain percentage of, let's say, historical gearbox remanufacturing have occurred. And last but not least, for the assembly and the testing, we have the mean cost of a little bit more than 19,000 euro, and the corresponding lower 90 and upper 90 cost are calculated accordingly. So, from this po point of view, I would like to finalize this presentation. Hopefully, I was able to give you a short overview, let's say, regarding this prototype we have developed for Permanus. And yes, it should give you, let's say, a short insight what are the different components which were developed for the prototype application. And I would my intention was also to give you some background information or what the different kind of functionality can be used for. So thank you very much for attending, and yeah, goodbye.